The Fusion Studio is a structure within the university that allows us to bring together industry, practitioners, students, and educators who are interested at this interesting intersection of engineering, technology, and live performance. And when we think about entertainment, it can be all sorts of entertainment, right? Everything from theatrical productions to drone performance and really everything in between. And so it's a structure that allows us to bring this community together in new and interesting ways.
A primary driver and focus for the Fusion Studio is exploring, sharing, and disseminating best practices of teaching and learning in this interdisciplinary space of entertainment and engineering.
The Fusion Studio right now is really a virtual place, I guess I would say, where we try and bring forward opportunities, right? So some of those opportunities involve things like our first Friday speaker series, which is free and open to the public and online, and it engages professionals across the widest definition of entertainment and engineering in this space into a, you know, a 1 hour discussion of what it means to do X, whatever it is that they do. And so everyone's welcome to participate and attend those virtual online sessions.
The idea of creating Purdue University's Fusion Studio for Entertainment and Engineering didn't come from the faculty. It came from a student.
An enterprising young first year student showed up at my door and she said, "I heard I could study entertainment engineering or theater engineering here at Purdue. How do I do that?" And I said, I have never heard of this. I don't know, but I'll find out. And that led me to a conversation with Mary, who revealed that there was indeed the opportunity to do a self-designed plan of study in theater-related engineering as part of multidisciplinary engineering. And so we started working with that student to create a self-designed plan of study. And before she was done with her first year, a prospective student showed up at my door and said, "I heard that you could do theater engineering at Purdue." And I said, "Funny, I now know what that means." We helped her develop a self-designed plan of study. And for reasons that we still don't really understand, and maybe we just sort of like the fact that it was serendipitous, or to believe it's serendipitous, so we haven't looked into it, but more and more students kept showing up saying, "We want to do this thing."
We hadn't really taken a step back and thought about really how innovative the approach that we were taking was. And so it kind of forced us to take stock in the fact that we were doing something special, that special sauce, if you will, was giving students a marked advantage mm-hmm. in the workplace. And so we want to give all of our students as much advantage as possible and replicate great best practices and share those across other institutions as well.
And students here get to do more than just learn about the engineering that goes into a live performance.
The Stage Machine Design Competition provides students with an opportunity to design machines to create typical stage effects. And so our first version of that was to design a device that allowed flower petals to drop beautifully from the sky, but have to be refilled without being able to get access to that device. It had to stay up in the air.
That really allows students to bring their classroom education to work in a very practical and tangible way on a team to meet an objective within a deadline and a budget. And that's been very powerful in not just helping our students learn what they already know, but learn what they don't know, learn from colleagues, which is really important in the world of practice, because we don't know everything we need to know. We need to learn how to learn from others in the workplace. And so we think that that's a great setting for that.
It may seem like a strange combination to study engineering and entertainment, but there's a reason the Fusion Studio brings them together.
You paid the folks in my industry a huge compliment by saying people don't know that there's engineering behind it, because that means we've done our jobs right, right? If you don't notice what's happening to make the spectacle, you're still in the spectacle and in the experience, which is exactly what we want to have happen. But everything else that Mary said is spot on. Part of part of what has happened over the last 20 years is that spectacle has gotten more and more complicated and requires an ever deeper and broader understanding of engineering rigor and safety practices. And that's part of what we hope to help enable students and practitioners and scholars to explore, not just what those things are, but how to teach and learn them in the best way possible.
Because it looks so seamless and it happens so naturally and often flawlessly and safely. And I think that's why often people take it for granted. They just assume that these things happen without the engineering effort and rigor and design practices that make it safe and repeatable over and over again. Anytime you're putting either performers or an audience at risk with our engineering artifacts and designs and interacting with technologies, it's really important to have sound, repeatable, safe technologies at work, not just to protect the audience and the actors, but to create great spectacle too.